Americans bowed out in the plate semi-final last year. And that's an intercept to Brewington. A fortuitous one. And that will certainly give them their momentum. So just a minute to go. Time slipping away from the Tongans. They need the bounce here. Higgins. Big trouble. Tonga can score. And they do.
Final score, American Eagles 20, Tonga 14. So to the second semi-final, and the crowd were once again behind Hong Kong, this time against Argentina.
Commodore goes down the ground side. Gary Cross is there, but he overbeats him with a lovely sidestep. And Cameron, the little scrum half, scores his fourth try of the tournament. Back to Shaw. Guerreras goes up on Shaw. Guerreras tackles Shaw. Payne collects it. To Crone. There's an overlap if they can use it. This is a great chance now. Has Calder got the legs? Calder has. Walker chasing Andy and Shaw. The only man going back for Argentina is Romero. He's isolated now on his own. Walker waiting. Oh, but he's beaten by Romero. Romero gets it inside to Arbisu, and this is dangerous for Hong Kong. And Arbisu's through. What a sidestep. Explosive pace up to the line. Will he get there? Yes! Or will he? He does. The try is given. His momentum carried him over the line. Calder puts the tackle and he's hauled down just short of the line. Now whether he grounded the ball or not is very doubtful.
12-6 the final score, and it was Argentina versus the American Eagles in the pit final. The Argentines started in determined mood.
That's smuggled back. That's Garcia Simon. He gets it to Arbisu. Arbisu's through to Irarrázaval. Out to the wing, Romero. Romero going hard for the line. Romero, will he be cut off? No, he won't. Romero scores, and he scores between the sticks, all made by the lovely little half-break dink and sidestep of Arbisu, and the Argentine Pumas take the lead by 4-0. Ball runs straight into Wilkinson, gets thrown onto the ground, gets it back to Camargon, the scrum half to Arbisu, beautifully picked up off his legs, off his toes there, out to Romero, Romero making his way through, Romero's going to score his second try in 3 minutes, his third of the tournament, and it's one-way traffic so far.
Three tries later, and they led by 30 points to nil before the American Eagles got their only try of this plate final.
Going hard, tackled by Camargon. Gets the ball to Smith. Oh, a lovely pass from Smith to Wilkinson. There's an overlap with Hines. Oh, the American Eagles will score now inside to Wilkinson. Good pass. Good support by Brewington. Andres going hard for the line. Oh, he's almost tackled, but he scores. And a thoroughly well-deserved and well-worked try. Good interpassing. And Andres back it over to score.
The final score of 36-6 to Argentina. We receive the play from Willie Kirkus, the chairman of the Hong Kong Bank. Argentina, the only top seeds to lose on the first day, but more than making up for that disappointment in the second. So to the closing stages of the main competition, the Cup quarter-finals, with Canada the only intruders, as it were, among the original eight-seeded teams. In the first game, Western Samoa proved that you can score against the Fijians.
This is now an undercut. He's lost the ball. Claimed by two Viaga. This is Viaga.
Game, if you're stacked up against your own goalpost like that, and you have a scrum put in, you probably rush the ball to your first 5-8, the fullback and clear it to touch. Here they may try anything. Let's watch. That's Bouliassi. This is Serebi. Oh, nice pass by Serebi, but they're still looking confused. They're right behind their own goalpost. Look at Noah Nandrew to break out. This is the halfway line.
What a brilliant score! Two more tries from Fiji, and they had won 21-6. The second quarter final, and it's the Barbarians against Australia.
Rupert Moon at halfback, Carling now to Guscott. Charged down by Little. Guscott in big trouble there. And because it was charged down over the goal line, it's back to the 22. So early pressure from the Australians. They look very hungry here. They've had a very good preparation under new coach John Maxwell. Sheesby, number two, been doing very well in the lineouts for the Barbars. Skinner goes high this time, beating Gavin, and that's a try. Moon has gone straight through the defence. Rupert Moon, his brother Richard, played here last year, and the Barbars looking very hot. Barbarians leading Australia by 12-0. Gavin went high, but they can't get that ball from the lineout.
Indeed. is Gord McKinnon. McKinnon gallops away again. Oh, it's another try for Mark Wyatt, and that clinches it.
The final score, 24-4 to Canada. New Zealand overran the French, scoring five tries, and this was their first.
New Zealand playing for their last place to play Canada in the semi-finals. Crowley out to Scott Pearce. It's a bouncing ball. The ground is hard on the second day. Pearce is caught by Weber. Look for Eric Rush, a very skillful player, and Sevens, and no better example than that. And he's cracked the game open, Eric Rush. With that try there, Gilbert Page came across. Wayne Smith looking at his watch. Eric Rush is a superb sevens player. Look at this. He hasn't kicked in 3 years of coming to these seven asides. He kicked there, regained the position with a leap like a basketball player, and then the way ahead was clear for Eric Rush.
The final score, 30-0 to New Zealand. There's the semi-final lineup. After defeating Australia, could the Barbarians beat Fiji? There was certainly plenty of support for them in the crowd, as you can see.
Fiji with 78 points and 14 tries for their, from their two opening matches. Will Carling. The Fijians know where the danger is. Will Carling very well marked there. Is out to Noah Andruku, who's had a great tournament so far. Koliate. Koliate going. Andruku is inside him. Koliate chased by Skinner. Caught by Skinner. In Gary, the captain. What a super tackle there by Guscott in front of the post. And Andruku once more. But ferocious tackling by the Barbarians. And there was a bit of obstruction there and a try given. And I think the Fijians will be very happy indeed to have got the score. Watch carefully. Andy Harriman went in first. But look how number three took his man out. That really was obstruction. Harriman. Harriman's the fellow with a genuine pace. Trying to go outside Thomas Ifama. And he's gone. Harriman over the 22. He has to go inside. He's going for the corner. Serebi can't stop him. Magnificent try by Harriman. Andrew Harriman has got the Barbarians back into the tie. Couple of very experienced sevens forwards the Barbarians have in Michael Skinner and Chris Sheesby. Michael Skinner on this side of the front row. 12 cap for England. Will Carling clears. Up comes Carling. Guscott was in front and Guscott is away. He's got a long way to go, but nobody's going to catch him. No one and Andruku isn't going to get near him. And Guscott scores to put the Barbarians into the lead. Jeremy Guscott, that's his fourth try of the tournament as well. He had three yesterday against the Koreans. Hunter. Straight and through. Barbarians leading by 10 points to 6. A whistle goes for half-time. And Guscott gets it going. Up Kim Sheesby, Rasari. Onto Nderi, the captain. Good tackle by Hunter. Rasari again. Out to Vesey. Along the line to Thomas Ifama. He's desperately quick. Thomas Ifama chased across there by Guscott, but he did his little hitch kick as well. And Thama has done it once more for Fiji. Just as he did, remember, in the final against the New Zealanders last year. That little hitch kick in mid-air was enough to take him clear. We get a chance to see it again. Twiggle, twiggle, and off he went. Lovely bit of running, great balance, good score. Great chance here. Koliate going, Nderi, Koliate, this is bewildering stuff. Marvellous players, Vesey goes to. Now it's out to Thomas Ifama once more, up to the Barbarians 22. It could be another score for Koliate, it's certainly from Nderi, and what a marvellous score for Nanduku. That was magic, magic all the way. A brilliant try. 16-10 then, 3.5 minutes of the second half gone. Guscott once more, just a bit too far that one maybe. Mick Skinner has it, gives it on there to Moon. Moon caught by Rasari. Rasari, who was one of the great stars in the last season thing, but it's the drive there by Sheesby, it's scored! Chris Sheesby driving over. So the Barbarians showing wonderful fighting spirit. And it was here when Rupert score. And what a moment. Just a minute to go. And the Fijians have one useful ball there to Poliate. Cerevi. That's a switch to Nandruku. Nandruku once again. Another brilliant bit of running. That's the clincher. That's the one surely that takes the Fijians into the final again. For their eighth final. And the Barbarians, despite a magnificent fight, have to go out in the semi-final. Fiji winners.